For I might try and play it quickly before I'll just see whether or not the teams are in the server just yet, as they have restarted things. But if you give us just a moment, we'll try and get that rolling. But other than that, Pete, thoughts on the map train? If you can just summarize very quickly.
Yeah, for me, this is obviously SK's pick. But in terms of the map pool for SK, they're very strong on Overpass, Mirage, and Train historically. So both of these maps falling in their strength. And I guess for CSGO Lounge, they really wanted to pick a map that they were good at, even though it is a good map for SK as well. And they matched up very well. Their strong map being Mirage, it's their pick. So. But unfortunately, they just weren't able to do enough on the back end of that game for them to come away with the win. However, this map should be more one-sided, I should think. And just having that level of expertise on SK and that experience on Train, I always seem to think that the more experienced your team is, the better you are on Train. It's such a teamwork-related map with a lot of hard bomb site takes as T, and you've got to be really polished for it to be an effective T side.
Exactly right. I am going to play this little preview of the LAN final, so hopefully this will work. It's not looking like it's wanting to cooperate. Enjoy. This is what the team are playing. How good does that look? Looks fantastic. I'm sure the teams are going to be really enjoying themselves in Split Croatia, should they qualify.
Yeah, it's a magical part of the world in Croatia. The beaches are fantastic and obviously known, that part of the world known for its water and its beauties, not so much its esports attraction, but certainly with a competition like Counterpit, it's a fantastic event to qualify for, and every team is chomping at the bit to get there. And as you said, some of the best teams in the world already invited to that tournament, with all these other teams vying for the remaining spots. So it should be a fantastic event there in Split, Croatia. And what should also be fantastic is this match on Train, because I feel as though Spero could in fact pick up the AWP and really do some damage. We saw some fantastic pieces of action from him, but due to the nature of, I guess, Mirage, a lot of trading that was going on, and not a lot of cover fire on Mirage, a very open map, and it lends itself towards that trading play style, I guess. Whereas Train, lots of places to hide, lots of individual skills that need to come out for round wins to be successful. Each player needs to contribute, especially on that T side. If you have a couple of players not doing much, it's very difficult to win rounds on T side of Train. Everyone needs to be doing their role to the best of their ability. And that's going to be the situation here, but Spero could pick up that AWP and go absolutely massive, because he does have the potential to do so, and we should be pretty close to ready for the knife round here, I think.
Yeah, I'm interested to see how he matches up against Freezes. We know Freezes the main AWPer for SK Gaming. Now, that's going to be a mouth-watering prospect of these two just facing off down the aisles of trains, but if the T's can really get their smokes going, what they can do is essentially place smokes down in the middle aisles there and really close the gaps and stop those long-range battles taking place. So a lot of teams nowadays on Train are taking that approach and simply just smoking out the train yard and really opting to take those close range battles. The CTs, if they afford a lot of freedom to the Ts and play passive setups, that's certainly what can happen in these matchups.
Yeah, and this map is so reliant on, I guess, the ability for the CTs to be patient and retake the sites a lot of the time, because the plants are actually quite easy to get on train. It's the post-plant positions, especially on that inside bomb site, that are really quite difficult to manage, because once you've got that bomb down, there's literally three or four spots to hide in on that inside bomb train. And if you're going to make it work, you not only need to get the bomb down, you need to be pushing up the aisles of the inside bomb, the inside train yard, and getting some advanced positions to hold off the impending CT retake. So, you know, will it work for CSGO Lounge? I'm not entirely sure. Sparrow's going to have to pick up that AWP and just put in some insane work, and they can obviously get it done if that happens, but SK should go in heavily favorited to win this map and close out this one 2-0 in their second game of their counterpit campaign.
But yeah, exactly right. They're going to be looking to maximize the amount of points, as we saw they won their first matchup. So starting the counterpit season quite ideally. And as we've seen so far, and I know this is obviously no comparison between the two scenes, but the North American scene is really quite hotly contested, just because teams aren't maximizing their points bonus. So they're really only going and drawing the matchups. So the best of two series really places a premium on winning. You really get a lot more points, as you should. I do believe it's sort of 3 points for a win, 1 point for a draw approach, but it places a premium on winning, and the teams that are winning, essentially, you only need to win one or two matchups sometimes, and that sees you go through to the top of the bracket.
Yeah, and in the best of two format, with the veto system they have in place, I guess the reason why we see so many one-all draws is because most of the time, both teams are getting an opportunity to play one of their top two maps with only one veto coming out and then the selection. So every team getting opportunity to play a map that they're well-versed on, that they have a lot of strategy for and are quite good at. So it does lend itself towards lots of 1-1 draws. However, that's why I think the premiums play so highly on that victory. If you're able to win your map, but also your opponent's best map, then you deserve a bit of extra reward there for in the point scoring system.
I agree 100%.
Yeah.
I think though, the veto system is a double ban. So they get two bans, but nonetheless, it's still going to leave some strong maps in the pool for these teams, as you said. And beating your opponent on the best map is really should be rewarded. So SK Gaming really want to get themselves off to, as we said, that ideal start. But really only going to be able to do so if they overcome CSGO Lounge here.
Yeah, and what's weird between both these teams is they have one of the most balanced map pools you could hope for. Both teams play almost every map. I think SK play, it looks as though they play Dust 2 and Cage to the least, but they still play those maps, and CSGO Lounge play every map. So there's no such thing as a bad map for these guys, as they've worked hard on a well-rounded map pool. And I think all 10 players are in the server now, so we'll be going live here in the knife, and it's going to be a big, big deal for CSGO Lounge to win this knife and get on their CT side and get rolling early.
Yeah, so exactly right. They're placing a premium here on the knife, and I'm interested to see which team does opt to try and stay CT, and which team obviously will take the challenge of going T side, but they're going to come to a bit of a front here, a bit of a battle in mid, and I don't know, I think for the North American scene, we tried to cast these knife rounds in a North American accent, so I will stray away from doing that, though, doing the disservice to these knife rounds, at least in the European sense.
Well, I mean, we can attempt the North American accent because it's at least similar. I am not under any circumstance going to try a Danish accent or a Polish accent. I don't think that's in my best interest at all.
Definitely not in my repertoire.
I don't think it's possible for us to even sound like that. It's not possible to override the Aussie twang that much to get back to that European accent. But nevertheless, Unfortunately, it looks as though the CT side will be taken by SK. So we could see a pretty one-sided affair here because of the nature of the map and also the side that's been won by SK. Now, Jim, I've touched on this many times before, but this is the exact reason that there should be a coin flip for sides and not a knife round in competitive play. Not just in this tournament, but in all tournaments. I don't think that the knife as a weapon has anywhere near a big enough impact on the 30 rounds of competitive play that it should dictate the starting of the game. It's a bit of a fun thing for the fans to watch, but for these players and their dreams of making it to Croatia, having the outcome of a game potentially resting on a knife round is a pretty serious thing. But nevertheless, SK will start on the CT side. And the
I categorically disagree, but I'll leave that point up to the next round.
You love the knife rounds.
I do.
That's all right. But as we see here, the CT side of things, they're just going to hold back in the train yard. And Magic Boy hit an unbelievable shot there onto Sparrow before Manice and Innocent do the trade game and get out mid-con to fortify this site. But Pimp will pick up a double before Acilion rotates around, and now it's a 2-1. But if there is someone to have in this situation, it has been Mazinho winning two 2-1s in crucial fashion on Mirage. So he's left in a 2-1, and both two members of SK are horribly low, as you said, both below 15 HP. Acilion only on 4. So this is a very winnable round for Mazinho if you can find the kills, but he doesn't have the bomb, which is going to be crucial. Freeze making his way around the back of the train yard, trying to find something, anything, just a glimpse of a leg or half a plane model behind a train. But Mao's doing a great job of just swindling between those trains, not making any noise, using his movement there. And, he does get spotted out by Freesin. A lot of damage there going on to Mouse. You know, he's on 19 HP, but he does have the bomb. And both players of SK have four points of health as he takes down the first one. And now it'll be a tense 1-1 and a much-needed pistol round here for CSGO Legend. He's got him booked. Oh, my goodness. I thought he was going to look straight at the SL. Oh, Acilion!
Acilion's got to be kicking himself after that. He had him cold.
Oh, that needs to be made. He's on one hit, and he's not able to make that work. A pretty tragic end there to piss around for SK, and CSGO Lounge pick up some luck there to start their T-side, and that's exactly what they needed. They'll win the pistol and grab those guns, but it won't be the easiest round in the world. SK opting for the double scout buy and the pistol force. And with a bit of armor being floated around, but Jim, I guess that was a round gone begging there for SK.
Oh, look, two bullets would have won that, essentially, for either team. I mean, as we saw there, the two hits going on to Mazinho would have won that. As it was, he only took one of them. Nonetheless, the two SK players were both on one hit, respectively, so two hits would have finished those guys. But nonetheless, they are just taking the fights here. Manice finding the first opening frag there onto Acilion, the man that could have won the pistol for SK and really turned things back in their favour. But of course, CSGO Lounge getting off to the ideal start in the sense that they actually got the bomb down and nonetheless won the round. So they are going to stream out into this outside site, the A site. That smoke will provide some cover for the plant. Of course, Sparrow not opting to take that cover and just take the fights at the moment. So just clearing the bomb site, really doing a good job of just making sure that there are no unchecked corners on this outside site. And two remaining CTs in Magisk Boy and Freeze are looking for frags here, there, and everywhere. Freeze not able to do so. He's caught napping by Mauzinho, and just Magisk Boy, the young 17-year-old wonder. Some great movement there from Sparrow. Just trying to find that frag, that exit frag, young Magisk Boy.
Yeah, and Sparrow will push into CT spawn and probably find this one as he jumps around. He'll spot him out, but the 5-7 of Magisk Boy doing great work there and taking him down. So he's going to live to see another day by the looks of things, and a pretty stand around there from CSGO Lounge. Great actual pace there. I love the way that they put pressure on mid and then put pressure on the inside bomb train. But then ultimately, they just all went out this small ladder room and went out there as a team, got the trade frags, got the bomb down, and that's how you play the eco game. So brilliant work there by CSGO Lounge closing it out. And so we'll be SK on another Eco round. And oddly enough, I'm a bit disappointed that they chose to invest in those scouts so early, because now it means in the third round when they go for that buy, they're not going to have an AWP in play, or at least if they do, it's not going to be with armor. But Manish and Sparrow making their presence felt out mid, they're going to take down the ecoing members of SK, and this round is all but a formality now. So the start that CSGO Lounge wanted, they've won the pistol and the requisite anti-ecos, and now they will go up 3-0 in this second map and look to push on, as they need to show more, obviously, in the next gun round, but this is as much as they could ask for.
Yeah, as much as they could ask for here. They just changed the tempo quite well there, funnily enough. CSGO Lounge just opting to get straight out mid, whereas last round they were a little bit more cautious in their approach. So already in this game, that as a T side, they're varying the tempo, which is just keeping SK Gaming guessing. And as you said, as a result of buying those scouts in the second round, the SK Gaming buy is going to be quite light as a result. So I wouldn't, as we said, Freeze actually going for an AWP, some armor, and really nothing much else. So the rest of the team, of course, having to forego the luxury of having head armor. So it's an interesting buy, if we were to put it as that. But nonetheless, they're going to put the pressure back here in the CSGO Lounge. But CSGO Lounge just taking fast control of these white halls straight through to the upper ramps of the inside site.
Yeah, and this is something we see pretty standard for a terrorist team. They'll take control of those brown halls between upper ramp and lower ramp and just sit there controlling that part of the map, and it's very easy to do, and it gives you a nice set of map control. And for me, I guess the worrying sign here is the only kit available on SK is on Magic's Boy, so they're pretty much banking on themselves to win this round via killing all their enemies before they get into the bomb site. So a good opportunity here for CSGO Lounge to take advantage of that second round force buy, where they went all in and tried to win the second round of the half. It didn't pan out. And Innocent will find
great
Pimp.
Boost
there through the window in the top of the small ladder room. So brilliant piece of innovation there by CSGO Lounge and picking up that first kill. And they look to push on here as the flash comes out from Innocent. But as you can see, they're just really content on playing the waiting game. Mihu just in that Ivy area, making his presence felt. But it should be an outside bombsite hit from here. Muzinho and Manice will fake that inside site, and he'll make his way upstairs. But Innocent will find his second kill of the round, and now the progression comes out from the terrorist, and Manice picks up a great headshot there onto Motti after he gets a double, and now it's a 2v2, and this is a must-win here for SK Gaming.
Yeah, just doing his best Keanu Reeves impression. But look, Manice just... Now, that grenade is going to catch Cecilian, of course. Cecilian catching Manice with his pants down, and now just Sparrow to try and make this work. Obviously, the bomb isn't in an ideal situation for him at the moment. He does find the frag there onto Acilian, so the pressure's back onto Magic Boy to do the dance around the trains here as they both up and down the ladder respectively. Sparrow, though, getting the jump on Magic Boy. Great shot there under pressure. And, of course, CSGO Lounge just extending their lead 4-0 at the moment. Now, SK Gaming, as a result of buying up in that second round, won't be able to force the issue here on what is the fifth.
I do like this eco here coming out from SK. They haven't invested very highly at all. Just a pistol each in the case of the four players for SK. Freeze, the AWP player, not opting for that pistol. But Magic's Boy opening up onto Innocent there. So great start to the round for SK. But for me, the previous round was all about Sparrow and his ability to use that AWP, manipulate the train yard, and find those two CTs making their way back towards the bomb. So if he can keep this level of play going throughout this half, CSGO Lounge might find themselves on the right end of the scoreboard. But as they are now, it's 4-2-0 with the SK Gaming roster on Eco. So this should be a pretty closeout round here as Manice and Mihu pick up those two kills and will make their way into the outside bomb site, and Mihubel should pick up a second, and he does, but not before Pimp and Acilion pick up a double. So now it's actually a 2-1 in the favor of SK Gaming, but Mihu's in a great position here to still win this round. He realizes the pressure's on, but Acilion, great flank here, and he needs to be careful because Mihu's walking back the other direction, just shadowing his play, and he will find Acilion eventually and make his way into that inside bomb site, and Pimp's left running as fast as he can into inside to putting himself in a position to win the round.
Yeah, and it's just a 1-1, a battle of attrition between these two players. Of course, Pimp is in a fantastic position, enough to hear the plant, but whether Mihu will actually realise and check his back, I do believe he's going to do so. Great work from Mihu, just realising that potential for Pimp to continue. Obviously, they had information, at least a little bit on his whereabouts, that the potential was that he could go inside as a result of, I believe it was Acilion falling there, but nonetheless, yes, Go Lounge are really taking this game to SK Gaming now. Obviously, have enough in the bank to pick it in this best of two.
Yeah, and in the previous round, Mihu picking up a quad kill, so that's great for him. Now, SK Gaming with a flurry of grenades will pick up the first kill of the round before Freese gets Spero as well, so that's a great pickup there for SK. The danger man for CSGO Lounge with that LWP goes down nice and early, and it's going to be Acilion on the quick rotate, but Innocent spotted him out, and great flashbang there will force the issue, but he's unable to connect to the frag. Acilion will take him down, and it's all left up to Mazinho to make this work, and it's a 4-1. I don't like his chances, and finally, SK should get a round on the board, but even if they do get the round, they need to be careful they don't get too cocky doing it, because if they lose one more gun, this could be a perilous situation to find SK in. They need to finish off this round as clean as they can and not lose another kill.
Yeah, they can't afford to lose that gun here, because that's the economic pressure being applied to them, as Mazinho is going to get shot in the back there, not checking that last angle that Acilion was holding in the SL room. So, of course, SK Gaming get their first round on the board and have three members surviving through to the next, so they are able to buy, but of course, there's still a little bit of pressure being applied to the economy of the CTs. Now, they need to be able to string a couple rounds together here, SK Gaming, if they're going to fight themselves back into this half, because already the deficit potentially could start to run away from them.
Yeah, and they will send the bomb towards Ivy this round, so a nice change-up of strategy here from CSGO Lounge. They're moving themselves nicely across the map, and unfortunately, Spero's left with just a Deagle to fight this round, because he's bought those two AWPs, and with such a low kill reward, it's difficult to keep that AWP by going if you can't pick it up at the end of the round or the middle of the round. But right now, both teams just pretty content on sitting back and waiting for something to unfold, but we'll reach the minute 10 mark, and every player apart from Innocent still on 100 points of health, and he's on 91, so very little action unfolding. But Freese will find Innocent just stumbling his way into mid-con there without any cover, and he'll pick up a free kill to start the round for SK, and that could be huge in the context of this round moving forward, but we'll have to see here as CSGO Lounge is. Looks like they've made the read to move either back towards T-Con or the inside bomb site. And there'll be, Manice running straight back inside. So, should be probably a 2-2 split here in the end for the outside bomb site, as the smokes will go over the roof from the T-spawn side of things, and the flashes coming down SL. They'll have to make this one work, because SK are all over that outside bomb site. Good flashes there coming in from SK, slowing down this progression. But CSGO lands, the grenades are really good. They've put themselves in a good position to get the plant. Ooh, Freese just missing the defuser, but Mihu will pick up the first one for CSGO lands on this attack, and now it's a 2-4, and a dire situation here for CSGO Lounge.
Those are coming in thick and fast, and Pimp tried his best Superman impression, just flying out that window to get the frag. Now, SK Gaming did a good job of just shutting things down, and really, at the breakdown there, just set up the crossfires as those smokes faded. CSGO Lounge obviously getting the plant, but now with that 40-second bomb timer had a long time to go to try and defend that plan. SK really capitalizing to the fullest. So, of course, another round where they win. Three members surviving through to the next and just starting to build that economy. CSGO Lounge, though, on the flip side of things, are going to go for that Deagle Buy that they attempted earlier in the matchup.
Yeah, and they won't get armor either, so they need to be careful about the speed at which they take this round on. They should be pretty defensive, and you will see them just walking, so they're not giving their position away at all, and almost like a single file progression. They're going down that low ramp, and they should be able to make something work here on the inside bomb site. They've got two smokes and a few flashes, so at least they'll be able to get in and hopefully get a plant, but Acilion and his teammate looks to be freeze at up ramp, just getting that AWP going as Sparrow and his team go fast down low. Great Molotov there from SK. The timing is good on that one. Acilion making up for lost time with that pistol round, picking up a triple here and potentially a quad kill. And he does get the quad on this eco round. It's an easy shutout for SK. Now, three rounds in a row and finally looking as though they're getting some sort of semblance of momentum.
Yeah, this is pretty much the exact same happenings of the first map, funnily enough. On Mirage, you saw CSGO Labs get off to that 5-0 start before SK Gaming really started to get themselves back into the match. So, SK Gaming, what they're doing in their first couple of rounds is really doing a good job of feeling out their opponent, finding out how they're playing, and just adjusting accordingly. Obviously, this map isn't being played at the frenetic pace we saw in the first matchup on Mirage, but nonetheless, CSGO Lounge are actually varying the tempo quite well, a little bit more so than they did on the first map.
Train doesn't necessarily lend itself well to a very, very fast-paced T-side unless you have excellent fast smokes and flashes, but the SK guys not getting caught off guard twice by that same boost. Freeze able to pick up that kill instantly on Innocent as he tried to jump up onto the head of his teammate and get an advantage through that little window in the small outer room. But now the round will slow right back down as we near the 50-second mark. SK just holding tight, holding firm. Three players still on that outside bomb site with two inside. So they don't have any idea really what CSGO Lounge are planning. But they've fortified both bomb sites and they have a man advantage. So this should be a win here for SK because the CSGO Lounge guys just seem a little bit tentative, and they've spread very, very thin across the map as they start to regroup now. But will it be too late for the CSGO Lounge guys as there's only 19 seconds left on the clock, and Spurro putting damage onto Motti there, picking up the headshot, and Pimp will find the first. Acilion picks up one, Magic picks up one, and now it's been reduced to just Sparrow after it looked so promising for CSGO Lounge in that round.
Yeah, look, just some hesitation creeping into CSGO Lounge's play. Obviously, they're playing with a stand-in at the moment too, which I might add is Manice, who comes from ESC Gaming. So, look, for a team that is playing with a stand-in, they are doing quite well against their much more fancied opposition in SK Gaming, who have only just made a roster change of their own, just finalising their lineup with moving Cadian back to 6th. So, Pimp, of course, being the newest addition. So they're an incredibly talented roster. Both these teams have really only had so much time to work on things, but we will see a bit of a force buy to try and support the one AK that CSGO Lambs do have. And again, just a slower start to the round. SK Gaming do a really good job of just stopping any fast pushes there. Mihu falling through that smoke. Motti just getting the better of him in that particular instance. But again, this is where CSGO Lounge are just lacking some direction. Acilion put under some pressure here inside, not able to prevent that bomb plant though, so good work from SK Gaming, or should I say CSGO Lounge, as now this is where the T's run into a lot of trouble. There is nowhere to hide in that inside bomb site, and simply nothing Manice can do other than take the aim jewels. So the bomb plant does come in. Their economy will be stimulated as a result, but SK Gaming just drawing back now on that 5-all scoreline.
Yeah, SK, as you said before, Jim, went down, 5-0 on the first half of Mirage as well. And I think that speaks more to the volume of the in-game leader for the SK guys, which is Acilion, although we've seen him not be prolific with his aim necessarily in that pissed around. Certainly his strategical adaptions have been on point, as he's been able to figure out exactly what's going wrong for SK and make the necessary adjustments halfway through their first half of each map. So brilliant strategy here being employed by Acilion and SK, as once again Magic's boy will find Manese before being traded out by Mihu. Moose firing down through that smoke and desperately trying to find a kill for his team, but it'll actually be Pimp getting the better of Mihu before Mouse trades onto Pimp. So 3v3 in a very tense situation here. Acilion proving me wrong, using his aim to good use there and taking down Innocent as Moddy just manipulates that train yard pretty well. He will find the first one, but time's of the essence here. And actually, Freeze has managed to get on this bomb. Pros don't fake. He'll go once again to get that one done. And Spero's left holding his AWP and saving that AWP, but really unable to win the round.
Yeah, just Freeze showing us that balls to the wall. He was sticking it through that smoke. Doesn't matter. But and they do come out with that round win as a result and continue this good run of form that they've seen that really has wrestled the lead back from SK Gaming. Just a bit of miscommunication here coming in from CSGO Lounge in the mid-connector. They're trying to get a boost onto this pallet with that AWP to boost their AWP to pick the top of trains. So they're, again, just opting to slow down the pace.
And yeah.
And they've struggled.
That boost there is a good one, but if you actually don't do it right on the corner of that crate, then you can get spotted out from the train yard. So they have to be very careful in their approach to that boost, as Spero didn't want to get taken down and waste that AWP. But we find Manese also with an AWP. So three AWPs in play across the two teams. And Spero's done such great work already with that AWP. And let's see what Manese can do. Freeze, a known entity with that AWP, been playing fantastically for SK at the moment, and now it'll be on Mihu opening up onto Moddy. So the outside bomb site will come in here, and Innocent, nice control there, taking down Acilion, and Mihu's gonna get the flank on Magix as well. So this outside bomb site hold has just crumbled here for SK as Spero finds Freeze, and we'll get the sixth round on the board for CSGO Lounge. And whilst the SK guys can definitely afford to buy this one and perhaps one more, the pressure is on, as those AWPs are so expensive but so necessary on a map like Train.
Yeah, if we just take a quick look at the scoreboard as we did before, we saw Acilion just on 14 frags as a result of being that solo inside holder. Of course, some eco frags or anti-eco frags coming in, some instances there. But, of course, he's doing the work for SK Gaming, doing a good job of holding that solo inside sight at times. But as we see, they've changed things up. They've moved that AWP from Freeze inside to AWP to the ramp. As CSGO Lounge just content to sit back. They do have members sitting in that mid-com, but they're going to push this smoke here. Moddy finds the first onto Mihu through that smoke. Not getting the better of their opposition in this instance. Moddy is too aware that potentially there could be that smoke push there, and of course capitalizing with that first frag. Now, SK Gaming with the upper hand here. CSGO Lounge, though, need to regroup. They need to put pressure on this outside side, something they did quite early. Freeze moving that AWP from inside to outside now and finding the second frag at Vines or Ivy if you're of the North American nature. And now CSGO Lounge under a lot of pressure here to find the opening frags.
Yeah, it will be Mouse trying to open up this outside bomb site, and he will make his way into cutout and move his way up the train yard. So good aggression here from CSGO Lounge as they're going to try and use this 35 seconds remaining to the most possible advantage, as Moose will find his way up. But Magic's boy able to take down Innocent, so the round continues to go SK's way, but not before Mouse finds a headshot at the back of the bomb train. So 2v4 with only 20 seconds to go. They need to make something happen here, CSGO Lounge. They can't just sit here waiting, and they've waited too long to make their move, and the SK boys have rotated over, and it'll be all over this round. Spero getting taken down the last kill, and after being down 5-0, SK have now taken the lead for the first time on DE Train. They're winning 7-6.
Yeah, just stringing six rounds together before finally losing one, and now potentially restarting their good run on this CT. So they need to capitalize again and put the pressure back on to CSGO Lounge. But CSGO Lounge is really struggling with direction. If they lose two early frags, which we've seen a few times, that's where they really struggle, in a sense that they suffer from indecision on which side they're hitting. Manise actually finding that frag onto Acilion, who had the jump on him quite early, and they are going to hit this outside site. Two opening frags there. Freeze kept getting caught pushing as Motti finds a reply. Does find a second as well, so good work from him in the cutout. That Molotov not actually hitting its man. Now, he finds a third as well, so good work from him already. But that bomb, of course, has been planted, and the flank coming in from Manise here on the inside. So, if I do believe this Magisk boy is not aware, he could potentially be caught with his pants down here.
Yeah, Manise is likely to not even pull the trigger, but Motti seems aware that he's there. Now, Motti's on a 4-kill. Posta, is it going to be a 5-kill? Oh, the grenade there, getting 7 HP on Innocent, and Motti won't commit to the defuse. Innocent didn't even hear him tap the bomb, which is unfortunate. Now, he will tap the bomb and find an angle. Can he get the spam kill? He can't, and that will be well played there by Innocent. Does Motti have the time? He does not. The bomb blows up, and after a round to remember there from Motti picking up 4 kills. That grenade that went into the SL room, I've got no idea how it didn't take down Innocent. He's got right down to 7 points of health, but CSGO lands escape with the skin of their teeth and draw it up 7-7 on this T side. So really, really impressive half here from CSGO land.
I want to know what shoes, what boots is that is he wearing, because that landed at his feet and didn't do any damage. I'd love to see that from the terrorist point of view, but nonetheless, CSGO Lounge obviously claiming that round on the result of that 1v1. Now, interesting for me, I don't think he actually heard the bomb being tapped, because his sound would have been nullified by that grenade coming in so close to him. So that's an explanation for why he didn't actually step in that instance.
Or we could not be giving him as much credit, and he did hear the defuse and just chose to hold the line because he knew Motti would fake the first one, as there was enough time there. But Manise is going to make his way inside down high, off the high ramp, but Acilion will snuff out that push from the CSGO Lounge player, and he will go down almost immediately as Magic's boy also finds one onto Spero. So once again, the danger man for one of the danger men for CSGO Lounge goes down, and now to finish out the half, SK just need to basically make this one count. There's nothing really going on here for CSGO Lounge. They've lost too many kills during the round to really make an impact towards the later half. They get taken down. It's Pimp to finish off the half for SK. And as I said, after being down 5-0, they've managed to win the half 8-7 and really start off, well, really pull themselves back into the game so they can start off strong in the second half.
Yeah, they need to get off to another fast start in the second half. But this game, these matches so far have just been a really interesting tussle between the two teams. Mirage was played at a frenetic pace, and that map, I think, was nearly done in about 35-40 minutes. So a 16-14 done in that sort of time frame really doesn't leave a lot of room for slow rounds at all. So Train, a little bit slower paced. It just seemed at times CSGO Lounge lacked a little bit of direction, but now onto their CT side, they've got to be a little bit more confident having picked this map, after all.
Yeah, definitely, and you can see the three players from SK making their way out. Ivy here, and Freese just spotting that mid-con area, but Innocent will take down Freese before Acilion trades onto the player at Vines, which is Manise, but Muzinho has managed to find...
That alias
does my head in. But nevertheless, great piss around there from CSGO Lounge. They'll open up their account early on the CT side and be confident there with their rifles. They've got two Famuses and an M4 in this second round, and SK have gone for their token force buy, and they will get those Tech 9s up and running with the armor. So hopefully they'll just group up somewhere and try and get out to the outside bomb site, as they've got 4 smokes.
Yeah, they are going to objectively try and take the outside bomb site here. By looks of things, by looks of the overlay and the setup, they're going to try and get that plant, obviously objective number one. And with those smokes, just shorten distance between them and their opponents. Those Tech 9s right up in your grill. CT's, funnily enough, I guess have telegraphed the potential they could be playing very aggressive here. That smoke into the T connector, just, I guess, forcing some caution out of SK Gaming, and more importantly, forcing them to delay their outside hit. So one smoke really just messing with the minds of SK, but they are going to put those smokes on a timer, and you would expect them to come out this T-connector. Malzinho's in a fantastic position to capitalize here with that MP9. That grenade does a world of damage to Pimp. And CSGO Lounger ready to take this eco, or this force fire, should I say, with open arms. Innocent finding the first frag there. Malzinho finds this frag of his own before he's traded out quite quickly by Pimp. But as we said, that bomb has been planted that time onto the outside bomb site, really quite short. So Freeze is going to try and catch Mishu here. Mishu getting the better of him. Of course, all members of SK Gaming going down.
Yeah, bomb plant's something that on an eco round you definitely work towards and consider as a success if you get a bomb plant on a pure eco round. But when you've got the Tech 9 and the armor and the smoke grenades, just getting a plant isn't going to be enough. With that level of investment, you want to be winning that round. And it didn't unfold there for SK. So CSGO Lounge on their CT side start really well, winning the pistol, and then they anti-eco. But SK will look to just rush inside here on this last eco round before they will have their first buy round. So they've taken aggressive round hauls, and they're just going to try and get this done. But Mihu picking up one, picking up two, ooh, picking up three, picking up four. Can't get the fifth. It's a pretty standard eco round in the end there for CSGO Lounge. Nothing really happening there for SK. They were content with just getting this one over and done with as quick as they can to move on to the gun round. Freese will pick up that AWP, and Sparrow looks as though he'll hold on to his mag and not upgrade to the AWP. So let's see if that that pays dividends or really makes or breaks the round, because he's such a huge part of their defense with that AWP. You'd think he would get that AWP as quick as he can, but the mag 7 push inside. Oh my goodness, Monty jumping over the head there of Sparrow. And he takes one down, and he should pick up that AK as well, but he hasn't. He's decided to stick with this Mag 7, which I'm crazy about as well. So great showing there from Sparrow, and he will pick up a second. No wonder he didn't pick up that AK. He's got a second kill with that one, and Muzinho picks up Magisk Boy in Vines, or Ivy, as they like to call it in North America. And now for SK Gaming, it's a matter of, can Freese dodge the CT attacks for the next minute? Can he manage to hold onto this AWP for another minute before he gets exposed and taken down? But for me, that round is all about Sparrow, his aggression, and his ability to make that Mag 7 work for him, and the gamble has paid off in the end.
Yeah, on a buy round too, nonetheless, they're showing some real balls in that instance. Now, CSGO Lounge winning that round against SK's gun round, and as a result of not getting that plant, we do see SK Gaming going for a bit of a Tech 9 buy. They will try and force the issue here, so let's just see whether or not they can, of course, get that bomb down. They do have a little bit of utility, a smoke and a flash. Freeze will be the one tasked with throwing that smoke to attempt to get the bomb down, but just a slow round coming out here, at least at the start, from SK Gaming.
Yeah, they should really stop it with these force buys, I think, but I'm saying that, Sparrow. Pimp Brother takes down Manice before Moose manages to take down two members, and Pimp will find his way around and pick up a triple. Can he get the quad kill? It's now a 2v1, and Pimp is left in a situation where he could get a team down. He hasn't, and SK just force buying there to not very good effect once again, and now you can see two AWPs coming out from the CT side on CSGO Lounge.
But look at the CT economy. Look at the money on Mihu. He's nearly on 15k. That's a lot of money to have in the bank so early on a CT half.
That's very true, and that's a result of the great anti-ecos as SK funnel out mid quickly here, and CSGO Lounge is going to be put to the test. Here is Muzinho picks up a double, and Moddy's going to be trapped in SO with that flame, and Sparrow picked up the early AWP frag, but it all looks a bit too static here for SK. They're not going to get it done. CSGO Lounge closing this one out, and the SK only really have themselves to blame for their poor start on CT side and digging themselves in such a big hole that they haven't They don't look like they can climb out of it, but they're going to try their best. Now, they've picked up two Galils and three AKs with minimal utility. So this is a make or break round here for SK, as the CTs have all the utility they could possibly want and more, with two AWPs coming into play. And Manice will find Pimp with the headshot from the AWP close range. So Pimp gets Pimp smacked back towards the T-spawn by the AWP.
Backhanded
by the AWP of Manice. He will go down, but SK will still find their way towards this inside bomb site, and it's a situation which doesn't look great no matter which site they hit. I think at the moment they're pretty much outgunned and outpositioned here by the CSGO Lounge players, but they will start this progression inside any moment, or rather, they're going to have to, because the CTs are just getting way too much information here about where they could be. They're slowly closing off all possible angles. You can see Innocent spotting the T-Con there, not seeing anything. Now the smokes and flashes will come in from SK. Manice will pick up his second kill of the round before Acilion trades finally onto Mihu, but Manice still in such a great position. He'll pick up a third too, so brilliant round here for Manice. This is exactly what they needed, as Muzinho pushes behind, takes down Moddy, planting the bomb. And now SK are in a world of pain, because they're going to have to force buy this once again, or choose to try and just let CSGO Lounge go into game point and fight for an overtime.
Yeah, they really could have done with a bomb plant there, obviously. Good job from CSGO Lounge, really shutting things down. But they are going to opt for some fast action here by looks of things, at least putting pressure on mid-connector early. So just waiting for the get-go from, I do believe, SL, but that bomb has been left behind, so if any fast action was to occur, the bomb is not an ideal place for that to take place, should I say. They have forced the buy, and they're not going to let CSGO Lounge have the match point so easy. Great team flash coming in. Mazinho taking the opportunity to push, but of course, Freese getting the better of him there with the positioning behind the box, so not an ideal start for CSGO Lounge in this round. But that Molotov there is going to just stop anyone potentially coming out to SL, if only they knew he was sitting in the corner.
Yeah, and a disappointing play there by Muzinho there. He's been doing such fantastic work, getting so many kills. He's top scoring for his team, and just a lack of discipline there has got himself killed in T-Con, and this really opens up the round for SK as Moddy connects with Innocent now, and it's a 3-5 situation, but Manice will go one step closer to balance as Ledry picks up another one. So Manice just going crazy with this AWP in the last few rounds of this game for CSGO Lounge, and will he find a third? He can't do it, and Pimp should be able to finish him off, but the action's back on Manice. Pimp will find him eventually. Now it's all on Mihu in a 2-1, and he has picked up 1-2. Can he pick up the last kill? He can't. Moddy spraying furiously, clipping the edge of the train, the bomb train, so not connecting as quickly as he should have, but nonetheless, he picks up the round, and long way to go here for SK, but at least they got a round on the board.
Yeah, there's a long way to go for them there. Moddy almost painting Mihu a halo with that bullet spray. So SK Gaming find the round, but they have a lot of work to do if they're going to get themselves back into this match. This T side on train isn't as easy as it seems, so they still have quite a bit to do in this instance. They are going to opt for a little bit of halls control. As we can see on the overlay there, they are sending two members towards Vines as well, so they are going to try and put some pressure on this outside site.
Yeah, and as you said, it's not as easy as it looks on T-side, because certainly CSGO Lounge made it look pretty easy on their T-side. They didn't win every round necessarily. It was a very close half, but every round they were in, it was a very highly contested half in which they started off really well, going up 5-0 and then getting heaps of plants before going really strongly into the CT half of things, and now they've set themselves up in a position where they can really make this work. Two AWPs on Manice and Spero, and SK just so hesitant to give themselves away at all, but this is definitely an inside bomb site hit, and here we go. The smokes and flashes rain down, but all the kills are going to go the way of CSGO Lounge to open it up, and now it's a 3-2 situation with two AWPs still on the CSGO Lounge side of things, as Magis Boy does find an AWP of his own and will try and make this work, but the bomb is down and he's all by himself with 12 seconds to go. So brilliant round there from CSGO Lounge. Magic's Boy hits a great shot there onto Sparrow, but it won't affect the outcome of the round. And in fact, the CT should have plenty of money to buy their star player another AWP. And they go up on match point 15-9, and an upset's on the cards and seems very likely at this point.
Yeah, a lot of pressure being heaped on the young 17-year-old's shoulders there in Magisk Boy. Of course, SK Gaming, just not really ever looking like they were in this match, unfortunately. They're just simply being manhandled by a superior CSGO Lounge side. As we do see SK Gaming really trying to speed things up a little bit, and we know how that worked out for them before. This very aggressive CSGO Lounge side, as you can see, Malzinho in a very forward position, and he's going to be in a great area to just stop that connector control. Backed up well by Spero here in the outside bomb site, but things are really starting to come to a header as Manise finds a frag, and it's all to do now for Motti. As good as he is, unfortunately not able to do too much from that position in SL. And more importantly, CSGO Lounge actually drawing this one up. Both teams actually sharing the points here today.
Yeah, they shared the points and also won each other's map picks, which is the really weird part. Of course, CSGO Lounge picking Mirage and going down to SK, and then SK picking Train and going down to CSGO Lounge. So brilliant stuff there from CSGO Lounge. They really played well on their T side, which set them up perfectly to just close out the game on their CT half. So well played to CSGO Lounge, well played to SK on Mirage. But over the course of the two maps, you could say that CSGO Lounge looked the better team. If a couple of lucky rounds hadn't gone SK's way on Mirage, that map could have ended completely differently too. So, brilliant series here. They draw it up 1-1, and a great start to the season for CSGO Lounge, and I guess a good result there for SK, drawing it up 1-1 in the end.
Yeah, very, very good result for those guys. I've got to be happy drawing up against SK. Of course, we have a double header here for you tonight. I'm going to be replaced by my counterpart, PK Noodle. He's going to dial in just very shortly. So we will actually be bringing you the action, I do believe, from Vexed up next against their opposition. And I do believe it will be Alternate Attacks. So that will be the next matchup, Vexed versus Alternate Attacks. The Polish team up against the Germans. And we will bring you that action very, very shortly. So stick with us. I do believe we're going to be bringing you the Vito live. Of course, I'm Jim Manesso. You can find me on Twitter at DeepJimPack. My counterpart here, I am PDG on Twitter. And I will be replaced, as I said, by PK Noodle. It's been a pleasure, guys. And stick with us. That match for you coming up very, very shortly.